Good morning, children. Very good morning. I welcome you all the cadets. So far we have completed the syllabus for class 7 geography. So I think you have felt bored by seeing the old videos. Now next class onwards, that is Monday, next Monday onwards, I'm going to put you new videos that we revise the entire topics right from beginning. So our vice principal has told us to put the new videos so that it will be definitely be beneficial for the cadets. So therefore we are putting the new videos, so please kindly watch the videos. Right now, today in this class we are going to discuss about the environment. The topic is topic number 1, that is environment. Okay, environment, that is next Monday onwards, that is next Monday is 11-1-21, class 7, and subject geography as you know well. Clear, children? Now come to the here in this topic, environment. We will discuss about what is environment, what is the definition of environment, what are the components of environment, and followed by exercises. Right? Let us come to know here, environment. What is environment? Environment denotes surroundings. Surroundings an object. What all surroundings an object means? What all, see, we are here. There are many things which surrounding us. Land, buildings, plants, vegetables, rivers, mountains, lakes. Surrounding us object which will be useful to us in everyday life. Ultimately, whatever is surrounding us, everything we have been enjoying by the nature, from the nature, environment, yes. Like plants and animals. Okay? The best examples. Right? And land, water, air, all those things or various components which is very very essential for our life, yes. Correct? So this is environment, yes. So the life depends upon all the environmental components, yes. Environmental components. What are the environmental components? We will discuss. First we will say about what is environment definition. We see what is environment. Environment is surroundings. Environment means plants, animals, living organisms. Living organisms. Okay. Environment. Or which surrounding us an object which can be satisfy our needs day-to-day life. That can be considered as an environment. Environment is an object which can be satisfy our needs, ecologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally acceptable. This can be considered as an environment, yes. Otherwise, the simple words you can say, environment means surroundings. Clear? So you don't worry. So here, the environment, here you can find the various components of environment, yes. What are the components of environment? Yes. There are three main components of environment. Three main components of environment is main components of environment is what are those three main components? Yes, number one is natural. Number two is man-made. Number three is human beings. Humans. These are the three components. Which are the major components of the environment? There are three main components of the environment. Number one is natural resources. Natural resources. Natural resources. Number two is the man-made resources. Man-made resources. And third one is human resources. Third one is human resources. These are the main components of the environment. Three components of the environment is natural environment, man-made environment, and humans. These are the main components of the environment. Children, they may ask question. Name the three important components of the environment. So the three components of the environment are: number one is natural environment, number two is human-made environment, third one is human environment. If you take the first one, that is natural environment or natural resources. Natural, plants and animals, right? Natural, plants and animals, land, water, air, mountains, rivers, everything comes under natural. Natural things. Ultimately, we have been using all these natural things, correct? Which is very, very essential for us alive, right? For example, I'll give you examples of each one. Natural, for example, take natural things. Okay, I'll give you few examples of natural things. Please. Natural things, for example, if you take, yes, you take, number one is land, water, air, where, and living things, etc. This all comes under natural environment. Land, water. Land means you can say lithosphere. Water, yes, hydrosphere. Air, that is atmosphere. And living things, yes. So we need, living things means all living things need the natural environment. That is land, water, air. We all mean living. Where? On the land. To live, land is required. Shelter is required. To survive, water is required. And to breathe, to live, breathe air. Air we breathe. Air is must. Water we drink. Where you live, land. Land is to live. Land required. So these are all interdependent. Land, water, air. Right? Interdependent. So natural environment. So natural environment. The best example for natural environment is lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and living things are the best examples for natural environment. Clear? Now coming to children. Second one is man-made resources. The resources which are made by humans. The resources or the things which are made by humans, made by the people, we call it as man-made resources. For example, here we can see man-made resources, example buildings. We can take examples, buildings, temples, bridges, canals, roads, buildings, temples, bridges, canals, roads, and even railways, etc. These all things comes under man-made resources, man-made environment. Man-made environment is. And third one is, if you come to human resources. Humans resources here, example for this is individual. Yes, family, family, or you can say community, community, or you take religion, individual, family, community, religion,
and what not,
even educational.
Educational, industrial, and even economy. These are all the examples for humans. Because when you take these humans, these people, yes, individual, family, group of people includes the family, and community, yes, group of categories of people, and religion, different religions, and education, and economy. It all comes under human resources. So these are the three important components. Which are the three important components? Yes, that is money, that is natural environment, human made environment, and third one is humans. There are three most important components of environment: natural environment, human made environment, and human environment. So, are you following? So here we discuss here. When you take the first one is natural environment, or here in this component, yes, these are all the examples: land, water, air, living things. All are the best examples for water, the natural environment. Land, that is lithosphere. Then water, hydrosphere, air, atmosphere, living things. That is living as well as non-living things. It all comes under this natural living. Now coming to the man-made resources. Resources which are made by things which are made by people includes this man-made environment, like buildings, like temples, roads, railways, canals, mosques, monuments. So all comes under man-made environment. The last one is the humans, yes, the people. When you think about the people, yes, people includes an individual, community, religion, industries, educational, a family, community. So all comes under humans, yes. So there are the three important components of the environment. One is natural environment, number two is human made environment, and third one is human environment. Is it clear? These are the three important components of the environment. Now you see about one by one. Right? For example, if you see living things, you see, when you say about living things, biotic and abiotic, yes, what are the meaning, the words of biotic and abiotic? A, biotic, B-I-O is biotic, resources, number two, abiotic resources, biotic resources means living plants and animals, plants and animals. That means living organisms. In the rest, abiotic means non-living things. Things, examples will be land and rocks, and rocks and minerals. Yes. So living things will be used. So let us understand these. By what are biotic resources? The resources which are obtained from the nature. The resources which are obtained from the nature. That is, you can say plants and animals. Yes. Plants and animals are the best example of living organisms. Living organisms. Whereas abiotic resources means non-living organisms. So by considering the resources which are obtained from the nature, such resources we call it as a biotic resources.
What are biotic sources? The word biotic means the world of living organisms. The world of living organisms. Living organism means the best examples you can take plants as well as animals. The best example is plants and animals. The second one is abiotic resources. That means non-living. The world is full of non-living organisms. Non-living organisms, the best example is rocks and minerals. You take land and rocks. These are the best examples for non-living things. Living things, non-living things. Biotic resources, abiotic resources. Biotic means living organisms. Abiotic means non-living organisms. Living organisms, examples, plants and animals. Whereas non-living organisms, rocks and land. Clear? Biotic as well as abiotic resources. Now we discuss about the components. Components of the environment here: natural, human-made, and humans. We are discussing. Clear? Now we will see about the important layers of the atmosphere. When you take about land, earth. We take the first one is earth. This is the topic. Clear, children? Understood? So far, what we are discussing is the topic is environment. What is environment? What is environment? Yes. Environment is nothing but as surroundings. Simple words you can write down surroundings. Otherwise, you can write down environment which surrounding us an object which can be satisfy our needs. In the natural environment, many things is available. Everything is available in the environment which can be satisfy our needs. What all you want, we want, everything is naturally given. Everything is available in the nature. So we have been utilizing all those resources and we are enjoying, we are fulfilling our life. That is what environment. That's why you can say simple words, you can write an environment means, environment means surroundings. Otherwise, definition right. Environment is an object. It is an object which can be satisfy our needs. Technologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally acceptable. Can be termed as an environment. That was the exact definition of environment. That was the exact definition of the environment. Is it clear? Since your world classes, environment means you can write down surroundings. Surroundings and object. Surroundings and objects. Clear? So this environment, of course, it consists, it needs, it denotes three important objects, three important components. What are the three important components? There are three components. Number one is the natural environment. Number two is man-made environment. And third one is human-made environment. Third one is human-made environment. These are the three important components of the environment. Now we will discuss one by one. So this is about natural environment. When I think of the first component, natural environment, we will discuss. Children, is it clear?
Thank you.